Howdy, folks. This is Rusty. Cowboy Rusty Nails. I got a story I want to share with you, but first, I hope you had a wonderful Christmas, a blessed one. And may your New Year's have been a happy New Year's, but just happy. Not overly happy, if you know what I mean. But if you've ever been out in the country and you see buzzards flying around in the air, you know that there's something dead or dying below. But those birds, well, they'll just turn in sharp turns and dive and then go back up. They're wonderful flyers. If you take a buzzard and you put them inside of a cage, let's say 6 foot by 8 foot, that's a good size cage, and you put it inside, but you don't put a roof on the top of the cage, what do you suppose is going to happen? Nothing. You see, a buzzard needs 10 to 12 feet of running ground before he jumps into the air. He takes off from the ground, and he needs that length to get enough speed up. Now, if you take a bat, oh, I tell you, now, those bats, I have dreams about them. Ow! No! One night, the wife and I, we were laying in bed, you know, and I was just right silly to myself, I think. And all of a sudden, I said, "Honey, did you hear that?" And she said, "Oh, what, you old fool?" Well, I said, "Baby cakes, I think there's a vampire bat." Oh, she pulled that cover up over her head so quick. Well, I assured her I was wrong, and she took it down, and and next thing I do, I go grab my neck. Well, let me tell you something. I kind of wish there had been a vampire there just then. Anyway, take the bat, and you know that they're so quick and nimble, but do you know something? If they land on the ground, they can't take off. You know, if they land on a level surface, on the floor of your house, or on a roof, they cannot take off. They need to find a place that is lower, and then they throw themselves off of that little plane there, and then they're able to fly. Struggling with all their might, they'll never be able to do exactly what it is they want to do until they find that drop-off point. Well, yeah, I even take the bumblebee. You know, if you take a bumblebee and if you have yourselves a nice, handsome grandpa cub like I got, and you put a bee in it, a bumblebee, now I'll tell you what, they will live and they will die inside of that cup, never realizing if going up they could get out, because it is their natural inclination to go down and search the bottom for a way out. And they'll die unless set free. Well, you know, all that makes me realize that you and I are a lot like that buzzard or the bat and the bumblebee. When if in our times of struggling, in our time of just being under the weather, whatever our problems might be, start looking up. He'll meet you. Well, you take care now, folks. We'll see you again soon. Yeah. Bye-bye.